my seminar will be useful for you. And I hope also that we will interact in a way, maybe during my speech, maybe after, we'll see. As you see, the goal of my seminar is the employer versus the employees with the trade unions between the case of university. So this title is divided for two parts. And the accent is the case of university. Why? Because as you probably all know, university as a specific is a specific workplace. I presented myself here as in two ways. I am president of Solidarity Branch. This is Polish biggest trade union. I'm sure that you know it, at the University of Zielona Góra. And I'm also a lawyer, assistant professor in Institute of Legal Studies, University of Zielona Góra, Poland. And when I was preparing myself, my speech, my seminar to show you here, I was thinking how to do it to make it interesting. And I thought that teachers and trainers start from a bit of the theory of the matter. However, I wanted to tell you how the trade unions appeared in my life, because it's not the usual way. How I became fascinated with trade unions activity. So this is a short myself presentation. According to my education, I'm a lawyer. I finished law studies in Szczecin University, Poland, a long time ago. I'm also a researcher, academic teacher on the Faculty of Law. And now it's Institute of Legal Studies, because in 2018, we had in Poland the reform of higher education. So now the whole structures of university is changed. My area is public international law. My special interest as a researcher is International Court of Justice and its jurisprudence. I am also, of course, academic teacher. I teach public international law, the law of European Union. But also I teach labor law. From a few years, I also teach labor law. So simply, I'm the worker of university. And I show you here, it was 20 years in Szczecin. Szczecin, University of Szczecin, and 6 years now, and since then I'm still in Zielona Góra, Poland, Institute of Legal Studies. Why it's important, I will tell you a bit later. And I'm also the president of Solidarity Branch. This is, as I said before, Polish biggest trade union at University of Zielona Góra since May 2019. So you can see that my CV is divided in two ways. Professionally, I am lawyer and I am teacher, and socially, let's say so, I have some activities in trade unions. Of course, as a Polish citizen, I always was fully aware of the big role that Solidarity as the trade union played in the political movement, in the process of political transformation of the country, of my country, in 1989, during this this process that has been called Autumn of People. But before 2012, shame on me, I have to admit it, and I do it publicly, so you can sue me for that. So before 2012, I had this quite stereotypical image of the typical union member, trade union member, someone who's rather noisy, even rude, who wears the down vest or diamond pattern sweater and helmet sometimes, and who most of all protests in any occasion against everything. Against everything. That was my stereotype. I of course I know it now. I know it from years that it was stereotypical image. However, I had one. And before 2012, I also had the stereotypical image of the typical union's activity. So I thought, like probably a lot of people think, that the main goal of trade unions is taking care of social assistance in workplace, like organizing Christmas gifts for workers, organizing different allowances, loans, any other financial social benefits in the workplace, etc. And sometimes I thought that sometimes the unions burn tires. So this is some, this it was, that was my stereotypical image of union members and of union activities, right? Okay, so my story in the university trade unions started in this 2012. I mentioned this 2012 few times, because this is for me like the beginning of, well, kind of new life in a professional way, also in personal way. So this 2012 has changed my point of view and my approach and my image about unions, about union members completely. And my fascination with trade unions activity began with the three important steps. And first of those was the participation of supporting for the election of the new authorities in Szczecin Academy of Art. Let me tell you something about it. Szczecin was, Szczecin as a city was lacking Academy of Art for years, public Academy of Art. And in probably 2005, the authorities of the city and some other dissidents started to think how to organize the creation of public Academy of Art. And this public Academy of Art was created in 2010. And according Polish law, in such cases, when the new university, new academy is created, first president, first chancellor is appointed by the Minister of Art for 2 years. So the first authority are appointed for 2 years by Minister of Art, and then there is election. So as you see, so if Academy was created in 2010, 2012 was the year of election, of course. And the person who was appointed as a president of Academy by Minister of Art wanted to keep his power and wanted to keep his position as a president, but wanted to do it in unjustified ways. There was only one counter candidate, but in fact the balance, there was a thin balance, weak balance between the support for the present president and between the support for this counter candidate. So this person who was the president was afraid that it will not be elected for the next cadency, which was for 4 years, which is supposed to be 4 years. Due to get what he needed to win this election, then president manipulated the process of the election. He changed the internal academy law, the electoral academy's law. He also hired few new workers who immediately got the right to vote. It was the election was in May. So if you know the practice of on university, you know that new contracts start normally in September or in October, not in April or May, right? Because the semester starts in September or in October. So of course those few professors who were hired in May with a very good for very good position, with very good money, with very good salary and other benefits, of course, were grateful to the president and were ready to vote for him. So the balance started to change for the benefit of the this president. Having in mind that Academy of Art started to work just 2 years before, you can imagine that trade unions in the academy, even if it were quite young, without in fact any experience. The members, the authority of those unions, asked unions of University of Szczecin for help, for support. Not controlling the process of election, but to make this election right, to make this election fair. I wasn't then the member of unions. I had this stereotypical image, and in fact, I wasn't interested in any kind of such activity. Because of some personal reasons, my brother was a professor in Academy of Art. When I heard about the situation, I started to be interested in the situation, first of all, as a lawyer, from the constitutional point of view. From the point of view that made me start to asking how in 21st century, in democratic country, something like that can happen. So I decided when I was asked for help, I said, okay, but in fact, I didn't know what can I do with it. So the unions from Szczecin University started to support those young unions on Academy on Art in the activity that goal was to inform the society of Academy what's going on. Because of course, when something like that happens, the biggest problem is that almost no one knows about it. Some people know, some people don't care, some people don't want to fight with it. So the main goal was to inform the society of Academy what's going on. In 2000, the first election, finally, after our work, after our big work, the first election was annulled by Polish Minister of Art, and it was repeated. So it was kind of starting point for me that ensured me that the activity in unions can be effective. Because, you know, before I thought that they just scream, they just protest, they just burn tires, and that's all, that they don't have, well, it was a bad simplification. I thought that, excuse me for a moment. Okay. I thought that if Solidarity in 1989, during this autumn of people, succeeded, participated in the process of state transformation, that was their big success. At this time, in 2012, before my activity for supporting the fair election in Szczecin Academy of Art, I even didn't think that it's possible for trade unions to act effectively on universities. Why? This thing will probably appear a bit later also. But if you work for a university, you probably know that university is a tradition. University is a kind of, it's a kind of structure, rather conservative. We academic teachers are rather conservative. For instance, since 2012, I cooperate with Szczecin Academy of Art, and I always admire their approach, because they are artists. They are not conservative, they cannot be. So when I compare myself, my approach, which I hope is liberal, it's nothing to compare with their approach, with their openness for experiences, for cooperation, and so on. So before 2012, I thought that university is a place in which this kind of cooperation, this kind of activity just cannot happen, cannot be effective, because university is this special kind of workplace that joins tradition and science, but among of people on the level of people's interaction, this tradition is the biggest tradition, conservatism is the first and biggest feature, factor, the first factor. I hope that, now my approach is a bit different, but then I was rather skeptic. So my first big step was taking part in this activity for supporting the free election, the fair election in the Academy of Art. And then I ensured myself that not only trade union activity is possible on university, but it can be effective, it can be even revolutionary for university, that we have to admit sometimes would be useful for universities, right? Okay, let's go to the second biggest step. Still not being member of unions, but being at the time the worker of University of Szczecin. I took part, I participated in so-called protocols affair on University of Szczecin. And this step was really big because it was connected with a very important thing, with a thing that I find very important also as a lawyer, not only for union members, for workers, but also as a lawyer. In other words, it was the fight for the high standards of transparency and for the access to the public information. The place of action this time was University of Szczecin, where we were striving for the full access to the protocols from the University Senate meetings. You know why it is useful to have this full access. Lots of important decisions are made there, like university internal regulation. The whole university internal law is decided on university senate meetings. Of course, we as the workers of university, when this law come into force, we can see it on the website, right? But who from you feels that it has, that you have any kind of impact in the process of creation this law? This is very important for every one of us, in fact, in every level of our career, in every level of our work. Of course, such decisions like salary increases, any other benefits, the vision of any other benefits, like... Someone has the microphone on.
Yariki kamariki, yariki kamariki, yariki kamariki.
Shall I take it as a suggestion? okay, so what university senate meetings decide? Salary increases, the division of any other financial benefits. It decide there is the decision are made about transformation in university structure that can be featured for changes in the employment algorithm. I'll give you the example. As I mentioned before, in 2018, in Poland was made a big reform of higher education. And almost, well, I think all university, but I'm saying almost just in case, almost all universities changed its structure. You know that changing structure is always a way to hire someone and to fire someone. So any kind of such changes can have its consequences in the employment algorithm. And all of those decisions are made in university senate meetings. So to give to the academic society full access to the protocols from university senate meetings is like to open the area of very, very important information for this society. Of course, in this society, there will be some members who are not interested in anything. It's always like that. Someone can be not interested. But most of us want to know what was the process of decision making. Who was for this, the shape of this law? Who was against? Why? Was it any kind of discussion, and so on? So the president of Solidarity in Szczecin University then decided to, I'm skeptic to use the word fight. He decided to act due to get this full access to those protocols. And this action was a bit, it was spectacular, but it was simple. He just took the chair and sat before the room of the president of Szczecin University. And he sat there one day, second day, few days, 2 weeks. And every time the president of Szczecin University went out, he has seen this president of Solidarity, asked him, do you want to see with, do you want to talk with me? Yes, Mr. President, I want to insist that you make the decision to open the access for the protocols of university senate meetings, because it's important for academic society. And first, second, third day went out and nothing happened. But finally, after 2 weeks of sitting before the room of president of Szczecin, the president of University of Szczecin, excuse me, finally, the president decided that those protocol will be transparent, will be open, can be visible for the academic society in Szczecin University. First year was with a kind of anonymization. You know how it how to do it. You just hide the names in protocols because, of course, there is also policy of data protection, personal data protection. So it's justified acting. However, from this. It was very strange and also very important experience, because from this moment in whole Poland, on a lot of university, started the movement to take the access to the university, to the protocols from the university senate meetings. And it was in 2013, around that. And now we have 2021, and since years, I think since 4 or 5 years even, all protocols from the university senate meetings on all universities in Poland are on websites. So that was the real contribution of Szczecin University trade unions to the to creation high standards of transparency and high standards of access to the public information. What is also very important, and what you see on the last point of this slide, the transparency of the Senate meetings supposed to shape the new organizational culture on university and to open the communicative area with the three main actors, the workers, the employer, and the unions between them. Why I say so? It's always like that, that if you feel that someone can control you anytime, someone can see you or someone can hear you, you discipline yourself. It's like you have lessons online, right? For many of us, the lessons online was and is an important experience, and we still adjust ourselves to do it. And myself, when I started to make those lessons, I decided that every time I have lessons online, I put makeup, I wear formal clothes, I have camera on, I will not hide I will not hide after the photo, and I'm trying to do it. Why? Because it keeps me focused. So maybe this is comparation, but I think that the thing with those protocols is a bit similar. If the members of Senate are aware that after the Senate meetings, everything they told during the meeting will be written in protocol, and all university society members can see it, I think that it keeps them focused, it keeps them cultural, it keeps them it's even keeping them from making some moves that would be seen, that would be seen rude or not nice, let's say so. So this access to the protocols, I think in the workplace like university was really big step, and it was thanks to university trade unions. So for me personally, it was the second big step in my connection with trade unions, because I, as I mentioned before, I wasn't even a member at that time of the unions. And this protocols affair started also the adventure that I'm participating still This is it was cooperation with Watchdog, independent, apolitical, and non-profit organizations like association, NGOs, responsible for making sure that certain companies and especially public authorities obey particular standards, for instance, standards of transparency, and do not act illegally. Those independent, apolitical, and non-profit organizations are called all over the world watchdogs. So such dogs who watch, right? There is a citizen, it calls Citizen Network Watchdog Poland. This is the association who works from at least 15 years in Poland. And the one of its presidents comes from Szczecin, also from Szczecin University. And it was law student, my student, one of my students. So I'm proud that I can say that I was his teacher. And this fight for the access to the protocols of university senate meetings started also the cooperation with Watchdog Poland. So it was a nice paid off because this cooperation is something, how to say it? Going back to my stereotypical image of unions, I also have to add that I was sure, quite of sure, even without, you know, considering the thing properly, I was sure that trade unions are like revolutionary body, that they are so, they do not cooperate even between themselves, I mean, between unions, and they are not able to cooperate at all. That they want to burn tires, they want to protest, and that's all their activity. Participating in this process to make accessible protocols from Szczecin Senate meetings, I ensured myself that unions not only can cooperate, that they should cooperate, that this is their must have, because it also keeps the balance of forces between university and the external world. You have to keep in mind all the time when we are talking about it, that this that the university is one of most traditional structure on the world. It comes from ancient times. It takes a lot from ancient times, from tradition. It's not bad, of course, but sometimes this tradition is an obstacle that stops university from development. And having in university unions who are able, that are able to cooperate with external organizations who are responsible for making sure that certain companies and especially public authorities obey particular standards and do not act illegally, it keeps kind of balance. It keeps connection with the external real world. It keeps us focused and it helps to develop also to the university, not only to the union. It helps to create, I said it before, it helps to create new organizational culture on the university, which is always good because this kind of revision, how looks organizational culture and how it should look, this is supposed to be done every year, I think, even. So I hope that you have heard about watchdogs. Maybe some of you cooperate with your national organizations called watchdogs. They work all over the world for the public benefit. So it was my paid off for the second step. And here I have some question for you. Of course, I'm not asking you to answer now, but I would like you to have in mind such questions. Maybe if you want to, we could discuss it on the end. And if even not, maybe you could answer yourself. Is, and if so, why the open access to public information important in the place of work? Why, if it is, it's important on the university? Of course, I said something about it, but this is my point of view. And I would be relieved to see your point of view. Do university unions or unions in general have any impact on the authority of university? How is it on your university? Do you have unions? How many unions on university do you have? Do they work? Are they active or not, or maybe not? As to the increasing and facilitating the access to the public information and to the university's policy in the matter, because every public unit, in fact, has its own policy in this matter, in the matter of the access to the public information. I must admit, I don't know how is it in Ukraine. I would be relieved to hear it. But in Poland, from 15 years, there is a big movement, mostly thanks to Watchdog Poland, a big movement to about this increasing and facilitating the access to the public information, because this is something that protects ourselves, that is useful for every individual, in fact. What does it mean, public information on university? This is also the question for you. What does it mean, for instance, is public information transparent rules of the financial policy, or maybe fair rules of the employment policy? Maybe it's something more, maybe it's something less. Do you think that academic society should have the access to such information? Or maybe do you think that it's danger, that it's not good for academic society? And some what ifs we have here. What if the employer is implacable and defends the secrecy of his, her decisions? What and if unions can do with it? What if the university structure and society are too conservative? Sorry, there is a mistake. Too conservative to open itself for transparency. I had such experience few times when I was already member of unions and I was acting due to increasing and facilitating this access to the public information. And I stopped because there was this wall before me made by some university authorities who wanted to keep the secrecy of the decisions before the academic society. So this is kind of questions I would like you to have in your mind, maybe to answer later, or maybe to answer for them to yourself at least, because I think those points are really important and worth to consider. And my third step in university trade unions was to provide wide anonymous consultations with workers. I was already the member of unions. It was 2014. And we wanted to make, this is always a challenge. We wanted to make kind of system of communication with workers in which they will feel safe, protected, respected, and listened, in which they will feel that their individual rights are protected, but also their individual points of view are seen, their voices are heard. So with president of Solidarity on Szczecin University, we created the files with a lot of questions considering the differences between particular faculties, because the Szczecin University at that time was divided for faculties. It was the main unit was the faculty. So we considered the differences between particular faculties, and we made files for consultation with workers, asking a lot of questions, a lot of things, what they like, what they don't like, what in their opinion supposed to be done better, different, and so on. There was some questions a bit controversial, like for instance, have you had any experience with mobbing on Szczecin University? Have you been mobbed? Have you been treated in a bad way by authority of your faculty or your chief, etc. A lot of questions we had. And of course, if you have such plan, you have to consider that some people will not want to answer because they will be afraid. Even if this consultation was anonymous, some people will always be afraid that someone can know my name and what were my answers. And of course, it can happen, but if you make wide consultations, like at Szczecin University, we had 13 faculties, altogether something, definitely more than 2,000 workers. I think half and half administrative staff and academics. So we got in total 700 answers, 700 files came back to us. And it was the first success because we did not count for it. We thought that first consultation will be such controversial, will be scary for workers, for teachers especially, that they will not send us those files back, but they did. 700 versus even over 2,000 people is a big part. So see how big part of workers decided to be heard, decided to be seen, decided to express their opinions. And it was really, really important. It was also consuming time and work because we had to make a kind of map with the most important thing that was signalized in those consultation, and decide then in when and how we want to act, we want to react for it, because of course we made this those consultations having plan to take care of those things that were signalized by workers. And something strange happened at that time, because we were called, of course, unions, trade union. We were called by the president of Szczecin University. We were called out by president of Szczecin University, who wrote a letter to us wanting us to stop making consultation, and even recalling some national regulations and saying, insisting that we break the law, the national law, having those consultations. He gave us a lot of reasons, but anyway, it wasn't the case, this case. In fact, because we made workers consultations, not social consultations. Anyway, what is important in this case? Of course, important is that people decided to take part in this activity. But also important is that there was a reaction from the other side. That was the reaction from the authority of university. And it can mean that the authority are afraid that something will show up in those consultations, that something that shouldn't show up, but it will be seen in such responses for this consulting questions. We didn't know how to take this sudden interest of Szczecin University authority and this sudden action to stop the consultation. Because there was the situation was like that. We are making the consultation, unions, and the president of Szczecin University says, right, in fact, you are breaking the law, the national law, stop immediately. You are breaking the law. We are breaking the law by collecting information from workers, by collecting information that they are giving us voluntarily. We are breaking the law. How? And then we started to think that it's not so bad, because there is a reaction. You have to keep in mind that it's not so bad if there is reaction. The worst situation is when there is silence on the side of authority, on the side of employer. That's the worst situation. If the employer reacts, even if he or she reacts in a bad way or sometimes in a stupid way, it's always okay. It means you can communicate, maybe not immediately, maybe it takes time, maybe it takes a lot of time, but you can communicate. The worst situation is when there is silence, because it means that employer is in position to can ignore unions. And that's really, really bad. So my third big step as in union's activities was to participate in the creation, this permanent process of the communication between unions and the workers. Also because this is the early system of warning if anything on university does not function well. Generally, universities are big units. So even if the unions are strong and big on such university, they don't know everything. The only way to have kind of barometer, to have kind of monitoring on what's going on university is to keep permanent contact with workers and to keep them sure that they are heard, to keep them sure that they are important, they are respected, that even if they are not members of unions, this is important, even if they are not members of unions, their contribution into the work of union is important. And I think this process of permanent wide consultations is really good idea. It works. I know it works. I know from experience. I've been there. So it's really good system. However, of course, it cannot be the only instrument for communication with the workers. Such consultation are also the plan for presentations, for presentation of the workers' needs and ideas as to the university better functioning, and finally as the common ground with the employer. This is the last thing I would like to tell you before I would ask for short break. Would it be okay, Professor Day, if we have a few minutes of break? Okay, no news means
no problem.
No news means good news. I'm taking it as a yes. Okay, so the last thing before the break, what I wanted to say, this last point on the slide, you have that white consultation can be the plan for presentation, the workers' needs and ideas. In Szczecin University, we had this consultation, and a lot of people among those 700 responses signalized that there is nobody who would be a kind of mediator between the employer and the workers, especially in cases like dismissals, in cases like disciplinary procedures, and on many ways they were signalizing that such kind of body supposed to be created. And we were surprised that there isn't some kind of conciliation commission, but there wasn't. Having this workers' idea, it wasn't our idea, but we took this idea and we put it into the plan, into the action. We prepared the statute of the Conciliation Commission. We also prepared some persons from unions who were ready to participate in meetings of such commission, and we presented our idea, this statute, the whole plan of creation, such commission to the president of Szczecin University. It didn't work then. The president of Szczecin University said, oh, okay, I will read this statute. I will think about it. I will consider. Let me call you later or something like that. Let me write you later. And since 2014 till 2016, nothing happened in this area. However, what was important for me personally was that in 2016, I wasn't already working for Szczecin University. I already was in Zielona Góra. In 2016, the new Senate accepted my proposal in whole, without any changes. They put it into force. So now Szczecin University has the Conciliation Commission, the body who takes part in the negotiations between the employer and the employees. And in this commission, always member of this commission is a member of trade unions, but the side of the workers is represented. Is represented by more persons. There is a union member, there is a co-worker, so-called co-worker, and there is someone who is like a neutral observator, but also from workers. So they have it now. And I think this is kind of success, union's success, and of course my personal as well. So that was my start in unions on university. I want to say also that personally, kind of paid off also was that I was fired from University of Szczecin in 2014. The excuse was quite a weak because I won the battle in court. I won the battle, but I didn't want to come back to Szczecin University, also because I found the new place in Zielona Góra in a newly created Faculty of Law. However, my whole experience there was very important, and probably as you see from those three steps, I think you can imagine that the activity of trade unions between, from one side, employer and the employees on the other side, can have unexpected turns. Can have quite modern dimension. And I think maybe you let me assure you that activity of unions can be wider, that this kind of movement, this kind of social movement, if it's separated from politics, because in Poland now this is the biggest problem, but if it would be separated from politics, is a real social force now. I think that those three steps show how, not only how unions should act, but also how unions should not act. Where unions should step in and where they supposed not to act in any way. I think that now we take a break for coffee or something like that to make some gymnastic. I want to, if it would be okay, if I want, if we will see each other in 10 minutes.
Да, пані Ізабела. Скільки часу потрібно? What time?
Moment. 10:17.
Okay. Да.
Thank you.
Добре. Уважаемые участники, значит, через 10 минут мы тогда встречаемся.
Okay, hello again, I'm back. Do you hear me?
Yes.
Great, I have a fresh new coffee. Okay, so this slide is kind of my conclusions from this first part of my activity in unions from 2012 to 2016, in fact. I will tell you later what happened then, but what are my conclusions from this first part of my activity? First is that union can have a real power and influences a real work life if. And here you have the list of conditions. First of all, if they have enough members. In Polish law, we call it representativeness. We have the condition settling in national law, which is that the whole number of workers in the workplace is in connection with the required number of union members to unions to be representative, to be seen as representative. What it means that unions that are representative, they have a real impact on the employer. Employer cannot ignore them. The employer has to agree with them some decisions. The employer has to take their opinions and so on. So, for instance, I will show you the example. Where I am now, University of Zielona Góra, we have three trade unions. Two of them are the branch of national trade unions. So first one is the Association of Teachers, and second is Solidarity, where I am. And the third union on University of Zielona Góra is a kind of internal union, because this is the trade union of the workers of University of Zielona Góra. So they don't have any, they are not branch of national level of this organization. They are only on the University of Zielona Góra. So for them, for this third union to be representative, according to Polish law, they would have to have 15% of the whole number of workers on University of Zielona Góra. We have 2,000 of workers. So you can see that this is quite a big condition. For us, I mean for Solidarity and this second union, we are branches of national trade unions. For us, this condition is better because we only have to get the 8% of the whole number of workers. So if we get it, if the union gets it, there are some obligations put on the employer. The employer has to settle, has to agree, has to negotiate, in fact, a lot of its his or her decisions with unions. So more members, more power. It's always like that. Second, if their member engage themselves in every dialogue with workers. I showed you before the break this example of white consultatives, but in fact to be union member means that you have your ears open, your eyes widely open every day in your work. You have to observe, you have to be sensitive, you have to talk and you have to hear people, because it has the impact into your activity in unions. When I came to Zielona Góra University, Zielona Góra is a smaller city than Szczecin when I was before. And university is also smaller, but a bit smaller, not so much, but it's a bit smaller. When I came to Zielona Góra, the union in which I am president now was kind of silent union. I talked with a lot of workers and all they were saying, members and not members, all they were saying that solidarity in Szczecin, in Zielona Góra University does not work. It's not seen, it's not heard, does not do anything for workers. Only maybe Christmas gifts, yeah? So this is not good recommendation for activity of unions, right? So it means that if you are in union, it's not just to be protected. A lot of people become members of trade unions just to have the protection before the dismissal from work. Of course, it works this way, but it cannot be the only goal. So this is the directive to the authority, to the management of the union, that you have to have members who engage themselves in everyday dialogue with workers. They have to know people at work. When I came to Zielona Góra, I didn't know anyone, of course, because I was new. Now, after 6 years of working there, I can say that I know something like 70% of workers. And I wouldn't know them if I wouldn't be in union. But because I wouldn't need it, probably I wouldn't even have any occasion to do it, right? Here in the third point, I wrote that I have such members that I did not see for 2 years of my leadership. I am president of Solidarity in Zielona Góra from May 2019. And I have such members of the union in which I am that I haven't seen at all from the beginning. I haven't seen them, I haven't met them, I haven't talked with them at all. So this is very bad situation, in my opinion. Of course that commission or kind of any other management body of union is the most responsible for the activity, but without your members, without their engagement, without their activity, you don't mean anything. As a union. So third if is if there are members are not afraid of being omitted for races or for the other benefits like trainings, like I don't know what else can be, like salary increases and so on. Here I have quite bad experience in Zielona Góra. I can say, unfortunately, that members of my commission are omitted a lot of times. They are not considered, for instance, to have recommendation for better place of work, for better position, just because they are union members. So this is... But I don't want to idealize. This is an ideal that members of union suppose not to be afraid of being omitted. Everyone is afraid of being omitted in your workplace. You want to have good position, a good salary, you want to have financial benefits, you want to go for good trainings, interesting trainings, and so on. But if the union works in a proper way, in fact, every single day, every single year, the situation will develop into the direction in which the employer stop to omit the union members because he or she will see them not as an opponent, not as an adversary. He will see them as a partner. And I know from experience that this is ideal. I was fired because of my activity in unions, but I still believe that proper activity of unions can ensure the employer that unions are not a danger for the employer, for the workplace, that unions are real partners in making the workplace better. Just that, in making the workplace better. Of course, then we have if their members are not afraid to lose their job. And that's something that I did not capital letters because of course, from my experience, I know how hard it is not to be afraid to lose the job. When I lost my job in Szczecin because of activity in unions, I was sure that my life has stopped, that it's over for me, my career is over, and so on. Now, after 6 years of working in new place, what I can say? I can say that I'm stronger. What does not kill you makes you makes you stronger, but makes you also colder. that we have to consider that. But of course, the situation with losing jobs because of your activity in in union, this is the tough case. It would be ideal, it would be great if the partnership, if the real partnership between employer and unions would get the point in which the members of union don't have to be afraid to lose their job. And I think that it depends on a lot of features. For instance, now being in Zielona Góra, I'm not afraid to lose my job. But of course, I don't know what will be. For instance, if the additional feature will be transformation of structure of university. It can be not only feature, but additional feature that I am the member of union, right? And the last thing that also appeared on the end of our meeting, also will appear on the end of our meeting, this is the unions, the democratization of unions. So if the unions are democratic organizations, most of them insist that they are, but there is a great diversity in their formal decision-making structures, both within and between countries. The meaning of trade union democracy is different in different countries and indeed within countries. Again, practice. What can I say from my personal experience? Solidarity is traditional and not democratic trade union. I have to admit it. Well, not so much democratic as I would wish, that will be precise. We have national level and regional branches and workplace branches like this one in which I am president. So In my commission, mine, when I started to be the president, I'm really, really trying and insisting to members of my commission to engage in every decision we make. I know from them that the former president decided a lot of things on his own. And I'm trying, if they have, for instance, doubts or controversies, I'm trying to make a discussion in which we discuss every controversial, every doubt. I don't want to push my approach, my vision to them. Also because I am a lawyer, and I, as a lawyer, I have to see some things from the legal point of view. So some things I see cannot be done from the legal points of view. And I have to tell them this, but they are not lawyers. They don't have to, of course they have to go along with law. They cannot break the law, but their point of view is also worth for me, because I'm seeing those things we are discussing about from many perspectives. So that's the added value of democratization in our little structure on University of Zielona Góra. But what I observed in regional branches, in national branches, this is a trade union organized rather in a traditional way. So it means there are some democratic mechanisms, but some others are not, are just not. Okay, I'll go to next slide. And of course, also my conclusion is that the power of unions comes from workers. You know, they say you get what you give. On the beginning, I told you as a joke, in fact, that my stereotypical image of typical union member was that it's a person who is noisy, rather rude, who protests against anything. Now, after almost 10 years of my activity in unions, I have to say that I met a lot of different persons working for unions. Some of them were open-minded and modern, with modern approach. Some of them were traditional conservative, and every one of those persons made its own contribution into the activity of unions. So there isn't something like ideal member of union. I couldn't describe to you ideal member of union. I only can say that every member of union can should have the ability to talk with people, to hear people, to listen to people, to see them, to see where union supposed to act. So this is the thing that ideal member of union should have. But education, other, I don't know, advantages or the disadvantages, it everything depends on the time and place. My latest conclusions from the first part of my activity in unions is that unions are able to cooperate. As I told you, I wasn't even the union member when I started to participate in this case in Academy, Szczecin Academy of Art. And I also started my cooperation with Citizen Network Watchdog Poland, with which I cooperate even now. So I think this is also the added value of my activity in unions. Unions, what conclusion I also have, that unions have developed from 80s, late 80s, and got the undeniable strength. Unions went out from this image of the social force who forced the state transformation. And if unions would put aside political bindings, it would be very good for their efficacy, for their ability to work for workers. Of course, the union's role depends on domestic law. However, some features are the same all over the world. Unions depends on the state's legal and political system. But most of all, more than anything, unions depend on people, on its members, but not only members, also people who are at least interested in unions activity. Spectrum of activities for trade unions on university, I think those activities are plenty. As I mentioned before, university is a specific workplace, which you know, of course. Workers on university are divided for the two main groups. This is administrative staff and academics. And the boundaries of this division go both ways, vertically and horizontally, while in other workplaces, it's mostly vertical division. The position of those groups are different. I would like to know, or maybe you can respond to this question to yourself, how is it on your universities? When I was in Szczecin, I worked there 20 years. I have to admit, and I shame on me, that I did not notice on the proper way administrative staff. Now, when I am in union here on Zielona Góra, in Zielona Góra, I see that we academics wouldn't be without academic staff. We have the two groups which has to support each other. We cannot see each other as again, adversary or opponent. We have to support each other. This is the only way to cooperate and to coexist on university. And this is also the challenge for the union, because when union, for instance, negotiate the salary, the increases salary division, it has to keep in mind the interest of those two completely different groups. The needs of those groups can vary in times, and the communication with those groups requires to use different instruments. Here I would like to give the example of Solidarity Commission in Zielona Góra. In Zielona Góra, as I mentioned before, we have three trade unions, and not talking about this third internal one, we have one which is especially devoted to teachers, to academic teachers. I mean, this is the National Association of Four Teachers, and second, Solidarity, in which I am. So in my commission, we have five persons, and I'm the only teacher there. And in fact, we have all together on University of Zielona Góra 77 members, and we have just 3 teachers among them. So the rest, this is administrative staff. So me as a teacher who know how to talk to teachers, to academics, to other academics, I had to transform myself to be able to hear, to listen, to the need, to be sensitive to the needs of administrative staff, to change, you know, to change my approach. However, what I can see from the side of the second trade union, this one for teachers, there are only teachers there. Whenever we negotiate with our president of the university any kind of internal rules, they are only interested in that what is connected with teachers. They never consider things that have consequences for administrative staff. So this is not good way to work, to act for trade union. Trade union is for workers, even if this is particular trade union supposed to represent the interest of all workers in the workplace. And that's kind of my conclusion also. Spectrum of activities for trade unions under university is this case of effective communication with workers. When I came to Zielona Góra, I observed that people talk around. They do not talk or barely talk to union members. And in being in Szczecin, I was used to talk to people quite in a quite open way about things on university. Here is I had to be rather careful with asking questions, with trying to have the feedback from workers, not only our members, but also from our members. It can be problematic not because people don't want to talk, maybe don't want to sometimes, but they just are not used to do it. So it's our challenge, it's our aim, our goal to make them to used to do it, to ensure them that it's good for them, it's good for university, it's good for workplace. One of the things I've been ever taught with the case of Academy of Art is, for instance, that the website of unions is not supposed to be put on the website of the employer. Never. Well, of course, you have the one on the website of the employer, but have also your one independent website. This is very important. In case of Academy of Art in Szczecin, the president of Academy put down the website of unions at one moment, and he deleted their mails and all information they had on this website. So you have to keep in mind that the website of the employer is always his property. And even if the law says that without justified reason, the employer cannot interfere with mails and websites of the workers, in fact, he or she can do whatever he wants to. So have your own channel of communication with your members, with other workers, completely independent from the employer. When I came to Zielona Góra, the Solidarity Trade Union hadn't have Facebook fan page. I was surprised, and I made it. I provide this fan page. this profile. And I must say, I'm not content with it because it's rather silent. Very often I put some information there, and sometimes I ask also the questions. What do you want, or how do you see if we do some things like that? It's almost never people write any comments there. So I don't know why, maybe because they are afraid, maybe because they aren't used to, I don't know. But the presence of trade unions in social media is very important thing. It shows to people, it shows to members and other workers that you act. It shows the activity. It gives them the power to judge us as unions. We have to be judged by the society of workers. Our barometer of our efficacy of how our work is done is the feedback from workers. How we can get it if the workers don't have any platform on which they can write or say that we are doing something great or bad or something like that. We have to have permanent contact with workers. For instance, what is also problematic with this effective communication is that from the beginning of my leadership in Zielona Góra, I cannot collect all emails of my members. We have 77 members, and I'm still lacking something like 15 or something like that email addresses. I don't have also all phone numbers of my members. And this is bad, you know. Sometimes you have to contact immediately with someone. And it would be useful if you could catch people, reach people in a few ways. Sometimes on communicator, on website, on social media, or maybe even on phone. Not everybody have the Instagram or Facebook profile, right? Investigation of the main problems in the workplace. This is the big challenge for trade unions. And this challenge cannot be made without the straight communication and straight cooperation with workers, just because some things are not seen from the point of view of union in workplace. One of the biggest goal and challenge for unions is representation of the interests of workers in front of the employer, sometimes even defense in particular cases. For instance, if we have something like disciplinary procedure, or even not so far, even if we have, if someone, some worker have a meeting with a chief or with the employers it's himself, he can have assistance from the member of union. He should have it. If the worker is afraid to be there alone, if the worker think that it may be needed some kind of witness or something like that, we are for him. This is also the challenge, and this is something that unions should do always. I'm 6 years on University of Zielona Góra, and I have never been asked for assistance like that. And I'm absolutely sure that situation in which my assistance would be useful were plenty, but I was never asked to do it. Nor any other of the members of my commission also, they weren't asked for assistance. So why? The answers can be, or people don't know they can do, they can have it, or people don't want to have member of unions between them and the employer. It can be good because maybe it's because workers see the employer as trustworthy. I hope so. But also it can be that workers see members of unions as people, as some persons, not trustworthy, not useful in the negotiations with employer. So this is also to develop, we have to develop the channels, the activities here and so on. Playing the role of the mediator. I mentioned that we met the Conciliation Commission in Szczecin, thanks to the activity of the union. I would like to make the one in University of Zielona Góra. This is still not done, but I'm making an effort in it. I think that one of the best thing that union can give to university are those bodies of mediators, those conciliator bodies. Because on universities that are this traditional items, the method of negotiation is, well, not method, this habit of negotiation is still rather rare. So I think that the role for union, especially on universities, is to start such negotiations, to make such bodies of mediator, of conciliator, to show to workers and to show to employer that those bodies can be useful. And balancing the positions of the employer and the workers. Well, you know, this is the situation. Well, if we are in front of the employer, the situation's always like that, yeah? This is the employer and this is the worker. And even if we work to make this difference a little less, those positions can be balanced like that, it's never like that. It will never be. That's why workers need unions. And that's why the employer does not need union, in fact, so much like workers do. But being this force of balancing those positions is also a very big challenge for union to balance those forces between the employer and the workers. As I see, my time is almost expired. I wanted to say something more, but probably I couldn't plan my speech in a proper way. Let me skip to the last few sentences. I had some theory here that could be boring, but I also have those conclusions. Here we have third point on the slide. Unions and the employer are not always adversary or opponents. When I started my activity in unions, I was sure that this is the fight. And this approach was bad. When you have the approach that you are a fighter, you are fighting for something or against someone, this someone in front of you takes the same approach. One of the biggest challenge for unions is to ensure the employer that we are partners, that our cooperation will make the workplace a better place for work, better place for employer, that our activity is also good for employer, because being sensitive for the workers' needs, hearing them, listening to them, and doing something for them makes them, well, makes them better for work, makes for them the work, the place of work better, so they will work better. That's also one of my biggest, how to say, my conclusions that come from my activity in unions. Okay, so I wanted to say a lot more. I couldn't, maybe because I talked too much. I hope that you found some of those points interesting. If you would like to ask me something or to discuss with me or anything like that, you can contact me by email, and please do if you want to. Again, I was honored to could participate in this great project. Thank you again, Marina, Professor Day, and thanks to Professor Osiejewicz. And I want to wish you a good day.
Спасибо большое. Оксана Николаевна, я вас отключила от перевода. Вы можете будете сейчас уже переводить вот, вживую, если будут какие-то вопросы возникать.
Хорошо. Да.
Спасибо большое, госпожа Изабелла.
Изабелла, thank you.
Спасибо за ваш вебинар. Действительно было очень интересно с практической точки зрения. Я также имела возможность работать в данном направлении касательно профсоюзов именно в университете.
Можете вас переводить, Мария Александровна?
Да.
Пани Диа Изабелла, профессор Марина Дей is talking about her very good experience, it's possible to say, in the same issue. And she thanking you for your speech. It was interesting. And actually, personal for me, it was interesting even for me. So thank you. Please.
Да. И направление именно сотрудничества университета и трудового коллектива
and,
в Украине такое же, как и в Польше.
The
в принципе,
same,
очень
same,
много одинакового.
The same, similar things.
Okay.
Да. Поэтому вопросы, которые вы задавали касательно публичности, меня
That's
очень заинтересовало.
Concerning publicity, I was interested in. It was very interesting for me because the public access is really a very urgent issue.
Но здесь, конечно же, мы еще не дошли до этого этапа, что уже преодолела Польша.
But of course, we are not so far as Poland in this issue. We are very, very in the past in this case.
Well, я думаю, что то мы идем в этом направлении и будем использовать ваш опыт.
But I think we are on our way and we will use your experience in this issue.
Hope we will not backing down.
Я надеюсь, что вы не повернетесь назад.
You know what I mean.
Вы разумеете, что я имею на увазе.
Да.
Так, мы тоже надеемся. Yes. We hope to.
Yeah.
Так.
Я думаю, что наши участники также благодарят вас за очень интересный вебинар.
I think our participants are very much thankful to you for your very, very interesting speech for this webinar.
Thank you.
И я вижу, что вы очень открыты для сотрудничества.
I think you are very much open-minded person for cooperation.
Thank you for the compliment.
Дякую за комплимент.
Я думаю, так же, как и госпожа Осиевич.
Same way as Осиевич, Miss Осиевич.
И если наши коллеги, которые сегодня принимали участие, в дальнейшем возникнут у них какие-то вопросы,
if our colleagues that participated in this event today wants to ask you any question in the future,
или касательно сотрудничества с университетом Зеленогора, или с вами лично,
or concerning a cooperation with the university Зеленогора, or with you personally,
я думаю, мы сможем сконтактировать или через пани Юану или лично с вами.
That we could do it by you personally or through Юана Осиевич. I hope so.
Please do. I would be honored.
Будь ласка, робіть. Для мене це буде честь.
Я вижу, что вопросы, если есть у участников, могут задать, включить микрофон.
See, participants may unmute and ask questions with the use of microphone.
Можно на русском, на украинском, на английском, пожалуйста.
Russian or Ukrainian English, any language among three those, so please, you're welcome.
Ну, я думаю, вопросов пока есть нету. Ну, как мы договорились, что в дальнейшем сможем коммуницировать и далее.
So we decided we will be able to communicate in the future. Могу я спросить, Марина Александровна, маленький вопрос?
Конечно, конечно.
I would like to ask personally, because